never had a problem. I used to run this way without the pipe wrap. I used to not use it. Never had a problem dinging or scratching water heaters. However, I was looking for a way to get rid of that extra thinking because I was worried about it sometimes. And so this is what I do. I just carry it. I have prepped the hand truck with the pipe wrap. This is an adjustable lashing strap. Comes with a hand truck and strap kit. Loose on one end, passes through a normal cam buckle, creating a handhold on the top. Radford Whites have short nipples. They're not very tall off the top, which may cause concern for some folks. I've never had a problem as long as I maintain a little tension, pay attention, make sure I have the correct setup the whole way through the job. Never had a problem with the strap slipping off those. This is a cinch strap, comes in the kit. It's got a sewn loop on one end. Adjustable rubber sleeve, adjustable cinch buckle on the other end with a sewn loop. This is what the water heater will be hanging from. This will be to adjust it tight. I place the handhold on top. Wrap in the back. I'm paying attention to keeping the strap flat. You'll find that even if it gets twisted up, it'll be fine. The sleeve works great. I'm trying to keep the sleeve centered on the back of the water heater. It needs to be adjustable due to the differences in diameters between, say, a 30 and a 50. Picking up the hand truck, putting it right in front here, passing the buckle and loop through the middle. Grabbing the handle. That's where it's going to hang from. I'm leaving this strap at about that angle. I'm leaving it loose. You'll see why in a second. I'll be picking this up. Rocking it back, fetching a bumper. Bradford's will be slippery on my bumper because they don't have legs. I got two hands on the tank. Correct setup of the strap allows the strap to pick up the hand truck. Don't even have to worry about it. Making sure I'm still catching my leg. Not gonna fall off. My goal here is to get this strap as low on the back of the water heater as possible without dropping it over the back. And then cinching tight. I'm happy with how little it is. Cinching as tight as possible. We're trying to jack this, for this install, trying to jack the tank up as high as we can on the water on the hand truck. Tilting it back allows that a little bit. Get an extra half inch or inch or whatever. This is a fender, protective fender, that I keep right next to where I set up here so I can reach it while I'm still in control of the tank. Hooking the anchor strap. Pushing it down in front, about like that, leave a little clearance. Tank will rock back on this, you'll never get it down. Okay, we're at a point where I'm a little bit concerned about the condition of that strap up there, whether it's still catching a nipple, but I'm not concerned about it. Here's why. I've got security here, I've got security back there, maintaining contact with the tank, you know, I've got balance. The hand truck's got it right here. This is the way it's built. I could probably get this onto this hand truck with one hand. What that means to me is, yeah, I'm concerned about how much of the nipples on top of this Bradford, the straps catching. But truck is designed to cradle water here.